Hi everyone, welcome to my 50th video for Epic Chess. 50 videos already, we haven't even been around that long, and in the comments box please could you write like what you want to see more of, and what we've done good and room for improvements and all that. That would be much appreciated. The game itself is the second round of the under 18 county championships. I was white against someone called Adrian Archer-Lock, who is 179 ECF and the highest ever rated player I've played in over the board in the series game. And he's about my age, I think, as well. And this was Greater Manchester versus Berkshire. The first round, I think, I was against someone from Kent. So anyway, after a nice break from round one in the sunshine, not much of one though. I was white and I played a surprise opening here. D4, D5, and now I went knight F3. Now, I'm sure you've seen I'm a Queen's Gambit player, but I can play the Colle as well. And I wanted to keep it solid against a high rated player. Now he plays this bishop F5 move. And what I should probably have played is bishop D3, bishop takes D3, and C takes D3, pairing E4. But I wanted to lock in the bishop outside the pawn chain first. Oops, before so I did this tame move, bishop e2, e6, castles, c5, c3. Now we've got the Colle pawn triangle with pawns on c3, d4 and e3, making d4 very solid, like a reverse semi-slav. Knight c6, knight bd2, c takes d4, e takes d4. Now I've opened the bishop up. Bishop d6, rook e1, queen c7, aiming for h2, so knight f1. And it's, as Larson once said, it's very hard to checkmate the king when there is an enemy knight on a bishop square near the king. And now black soon turns his attention to the queen side. After castles, h6 is probably best here because to give the bishop a retreat square, because I could have got knight h4 here. And after bishop b4, provoking f3, bishop g6, knight takes g6, h takes g6. White has a bishop pair, although black has a slightly more active position, making chances even. Plus f3 is a weakening move. But I had to play f3 to win the bishop pair. Instead, I go bishop d3, and after bishop takes d3, queen takes d3, rook ab8. By the way, he had used, I think, less than a minute at this point of the game. And he played very fast all the way throughout the game, probably hoping to kill me as quick as possible. I was quite happy though, because it meant the game won't last a long time. And then the second ever video we did, it was actually at the championships. You know that dual commentary between me and Tim Chatties and our game at Haywood. That was like our first ever video, and we did it while we was there. And we needed like time to do it after this game. Because we tried to do it after the game against Conor Murphy, but annoying little kids kept interrupting us, which was rather annoying. This is actually basically around where Epic Chess started as well, around this time, when I played this game. Anyway, knight g3, b5, now he's trying to hack me up on the queen side. Bishop g5, threatening bishop takes f6, so knight d7. Rook ac1. b4. c4, threatening to win the bishop with c5. And white actually starts getting the upper hand now. Because the best here is bishop takes g3, h takes g3, queen a5, c takes d5, queen takes d5, and white is slightly better here, despite the isolated d pawn. Instead, he plays d takes c4, queen takes c4, threatening to win a piece, and the queen's pinned, so rook fc8. And now I should have, when you've got an isolated queen's pawn, you should always look for an opportunity to advance it at a favourable moment. And here is an example. I should have gone d5, e takes d5, queen takes d5, knight b6, and queen e4 with a very strong position. Black's queen is in danger. Moves like knight f5 are coming, if black doesn't take it. And white has a strong e-file pressure and a very good position. And it's got rid of the weakness. Instead, I play a timid move, queen d3, queen a5, knight e4, and now he plays a bit of a blunder with bishop e7 through blitzing, I'd say. He should he should have played queen d5 here with a strong centralized queen. Instead, after bishop e7, I should have gone rook takes. Sorry about that. I should have gone rook takes c6, removing the guard of the e7 bishop. There is no in between move because black's rook goes with check, so rook takes c6, bishop takes e7, queen takes a2. Even material, but knight c5. Black's queen is horribly outreplaced. Knight takes c5, d takes c5, and if queen takes b2, trying to win a pawn, the knight is hammered by knight g5, f5, and queen d7. Black's e6 pawn is attacked 3 times. The rook's on pre, and the e6 pawn is going to fall, and white will mate very quickly, I'd say, in this position, or win loads of material. Instead, I play bishop takes e7, not having a clue. Knight takes e7, knight eg5, and also around this point, I was already far behind on clock, but I was spending loads of like valuable minutes on in a fast time control and like pointless sacrifices that were never going to work. Like an e6, I was going to sacrifice an e6 and f7 every move until one actually finally works in a few moves' time. Knight f8. Again, very hard to make the king when the knight's in a bishop square, but my queen side is slowly getting hacked, so I have to do something. Queen b3, defending the queen side and putting more pressure on e6. Knight f5. h4. Finally getting impatient. And now, ironically, that the only time in the game where he thinks for more than a minute, he actually makes a horrible blunder with knight g6. Now you can see why he plays dead fast. He should have played rook takes c1. Rook takes c1, h6, knight e4, and queen back to d8. And black has got strong. Black is going to win a pawn here with all this pressure on my pawns, but I do have an active position, so it's about equal. However, he plays knight g6, and see if you can quickly. After rook takes c8, rook takes c8. See if you can quickly find. There's three killing moves here, and I play the simplest because I only had 10 minutes left against an hour. See if you can spot one of them quickly. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I went knight takes f7, where king takes f7 is nonsense because of queen takes e6 followed by queen takes c8 and a quick mate. And I'm up a rook. Well, the exchange. However, well, there is also a few other good moves, like rook takes e6 is one of them. Again, pawn takes queen takes e6 check, so rook c1 check. King h2, queen c7 check. There's a little amusing line there I found, which if king h3, then that gets hammered by check, check, and mate. What do you think of that continuation I found? Mate with just knights. But anyway, of course, I just go g3, knight f8, rook e5, and white is a pawn up with a crushing position. Instead, I play knight takes f7, just as crushing. And after queen d5 is the only move to stay in the game. Well, not got much time left. If I trade queens off, I will have a good endgame advantage. Up a pawn up, good winning chances, but can I really win it? Well, I should have gone knight 7 g5 is the best way. Queen takes, pawn takes, knight takes, knight takes, knight takes, knight takes e6. Although I've got double b pawns. The D pawn, the strong knight in e6, and the rook on the open file compared to black's misplaced knight are going to win the game quite easily. I get greedy and play the dreadful blunder, rook takes e6, forgetting he can just trade queens off and play king takes f7, and now all of a sudden, I'm a piece down for two pawns in an endgame. Worse still, my pawn structure is completely fractured. However, there still is chances. Knight g5, king g8, rook a6. Around this point as well, there was a pretty amusing moment because they had these like really bad analog clocks where they said on stuff like Maidenhead Congress 1983, and you could tell they were bad because the clock I played on in both games, it kept like, you could hardly press it and you had to like ram it down like sometimes really hard. And in fact, around this time when he made his move, he like pressed the clock and it kind of like shot up, it did, the spring just went out and it just practically went flying up. And it happened a couple of moves later as well. Couldn't believe that. It was pretty funny though. I needed something to cheer me up after that blunder. And there's no chance of winning on clock, seeing as he has about 50 minutes against 5 minutes at this point. Knight takes d4, rook takes a7, rook b8. Knight takes h4 is even more crushing. Rook b8 gives me a bit of a chance because I go rook d7 and I'm forcing his knight away from e6. And once my knight comes on e6, he cannot defend g7. However, he can play knight f8. Rook e8, however, is better. Rook takes g7, checking h8, loses a piece. So, knight takes g7, rook e1 check, king h2, rook e2, and now a pawn's drop in here, and then black's b pawn will pass to decide the game. Knight f8 is good, because after rook takes g7 check, king h8, I have to defend the knight, and now he swaps them off. And I have maintained 2 pawns for the piece, which is good, but I'm still a piece down, and after knight c5, rook e3, rook d8, he's took an open file now. I play b3, however, he now has rook d3, and after rook takes d3, knight takes d3, the evaluation at this point is minus 88. I could have resigned, but in desperate time trouble, I play on a few more moves with king f1, knight c1. I was just hoping the kingside pawns might do something, but now king e1, knight takes b3, king d1, knight d4. Then I start pushing him with h5, king g7, f4, king f6, g4. Ooh, might get something going here. Knight e6, f5, knight c5, king c2, king g5, and now I resign. Because what happens is, he'll pick the g4 and h5 pawns off by force, and if my f-pawn tries to run away, he plays knight e6, stopping it for good. And even if this forces me to, even if I can win his b-pawn, his knight and h-pawn will win the game. It's a shame, because if he didn't have an extra knight, then I'd get a draw then. But serves him right for blundering that piece. Anyway, here I should have beaten the 179 ECF, should have drawn against the 178, blah, 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 blah. But in a group full of 170s, I didn't look out of place at 141. No way I should have got 0 out of 2, but it was I had a good time, good laugh on coach, did a video as well while we was there. And I hope you enjoyed my 50th video. There is many more to come in the future. Please leave any comments and thoughts. Thanks very much.